Good morning. Thank you for coming to the house of the Lord. I appreciate you being here today. Let me begin by saying there is a correction to the bulletin. The bulletin says that Bishop Kanjuye, who is the National Overseer of Zambia and Angola, is going to be here on Sunday, April the 24th. Actually, that's supposed to say Sunday, August the 24th. 25th? Well, it's going to be next Sunday. I put it down in a note, an email to Glenn, and she copied and pasted it, so it was entirely her fault for marrying me. So, but we'll let her slide on that. So, Bishop Kanjuye will be here next Sunday. Some of you remember he came 2 years ago, and so he's going to give us some updates, I'm sure, on what's going on there. It's a wonderful, wonderful man. He and Adam have been in touch through the last couple of years a little bit. So I'm excited about seeing the bishop. And so let's see. Scott, I'd like to make you responsible for something next week. Last year when he came, or 2 years ago, he actually sat in the back. And I thought, well, maybe that's how they do it, you know. But since then, I have reflected, and I thought, you know, he's probably waiting for someone to invite him to the front. So, if you'll help me remember, just remind me next week when he comes, what I want to do is escort him up to the front. Because maybe he was doing that out of respect, and I don't want to assume I can sit in the front. So help me with that. When I used to travel from church to church years ago, working for the state office, very often I would sit near the front. Does anybody know why? Because I wasn't worried about taking anybody's seat. Because I remember one time in particular, I sat in a seat and it wasn't in the front, and an older woman came up to me. She said, "Excuse me, sir," and I stood up and greeted her. I said, "Good morning." She said, "Good morning, you're in my seat." There were plenty of other seats, but that was her seat. So, anyway, thank the Lord. Let's see. I got a couple things I need to do, so I think I'll start with those, if that's okay. Some of you received a text message from me this morning letting you know that Bobby Meeks passed away about 1:30 this morning. And I know his health has not been good, but I hadn't heard that he was near death or anything like that, so I suspect that it was probably something very sudden for the family. And so we need to pray for the Meeks family. So why don't we do that right now? If it was your father, your husband, your brother, your relative, actually, he's part of our family, family's God, you would want somebody praying for you. So would you stand? Let's pray for the Meeks family that God would comfort them. Would you pray with me? Dear Jesus, we thank you because your word is true and your word teaches us that you are faithful. Thank you for being faithful to us. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, Tabby and Wanda need your faithful touch. Holy Spirit, they need your touch of comfort and peace. I know this will be a challenging time for this family. But we all know that death is part of life. It's just the way that things work in our life for now, not forever. One day we'll be in a place where there is no death. If we know you, surrender to you, give our heart to you, let you live in our hearts, then Lord, we won't have to experience death over and over again with people we love. But we're not there yet, so while we live in this time, it's something that we all have experienced, and I just pray for your comfort. Pray for your peace. Be with Wanda. She makes the final arrangements. Help everyone around this family to show them love and concern. Lord, we lift them up. We are doing this in obedience to your word. Jesus, you taught us that you would have others do to you, do the same then. Treat others the way you want to be treated. That's what we're doing. We would certainly want somebody praying for us. Would you comfort Wanda as she mourns the loss of her husband, Tabby, and her family as they mourn the loss of a father, grandfather? Bless them, Jesus. Touch them for your glory, Jesus. Lord, as you do this, as you hear our prayers, and we know that you will answer, we know this is in obedience to your will. It's according to your will to comfort people, so we trust you. Believe you will answer. started school. Kevin, you're in school already, right? Khaled, you're in school. What grade are you in now? Kindergarten? Kindergarten. And just so you know, there's no babies in kindergarten. They're all big boys and girls, right? They're all big boys and girls, Caleb. Right? See, he told me that this morning. So I'm thankful for that. So the church would like to do something to help you. What we'd like to do is we'd like to give a gift card, a $20 gift card from Walmart to help you buy some school supplies. Now, since I already messed up the bulletin, I can tell you about the gift cards. Yesterday evening, I went to Walmart to get the gift cards, and I could tell that she was giving me the right amount because I was watching it add up to the total, and so I paid her. Sometimes when she tried to validate a card, it wouldn't work, so she put it in another pile. And so it was the right amount, so I took them home, and I got it in my pocket. And this morning, I was in my office, and I counted them, and I have one card more than what I paid for. So I told my lovely wife, or I asked her, I said, would you count them? So Glenda counted them, and she says, yes, you have one more than you should. And I was at first thinking I got a free card and I had to take it back to Walmart. She said, no, she probably put one of the bad cards in the stack of the good cards. So you can go online, you scratch off the back, you can go online, then you have the whole number and the little PIN code. You can go online and see how much the value is. So before you take this to Walmart, you may want to do that. So you don't go there and try to pay for something. They say, this card is no good. Where did you steal it from? Okay? You can tell them, simply tell them your pastor stole it. No, don't do that. Don't do that. But what you certainly want to do is you would want to check it first before you go, and then if it says there's no value, just contact me and I'll make it right for you. So I was thinking about doing something that I know some of the young people in here will really enjoy, to ask you to come up front. We're going to pray for you, but... you know, when I was thinking about that, Lennon, I was thinking, Lennon's probably going to say, I don't want to go up front. Do you, dear? How about if we do this? If you're in school of any sort, if you're in school, would you stand? Just a moment, would you stand? How about that? I'll ask you to stand. That'd be easier. Okay, school. Levántese, por favor, Caleb. Okay. Caleb says, I am standing. Okay, remain standing for just a moment. Okay, Glenna, come help me, would you? Now, if you work in school, would you stand too? Because we want to pray for you too. Go ahead. Yes. Okay. Thank the Lord. Okay, Glenna, I'm going to ask you if you would have prayer not only for these students, but the other students in our church that attend school and for these folks that act like they work in school. Maybe sometimes. Would you pray for them?
Thank you, Lord. Just thankful that we have students here and teachers here. They're both very important people to us. And I just pray that you would minister their hearts, their minds, their bodies, their spirits, Lord, as they go back and the teachers are working. The students are too, because they're having to learn new things and get used to new situations that they're in. And I just pray a covering over them all right now in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, I pray that you would surround them. Lord, that they would feel your presence everywhere they go. And that every step they take, they'll be following you. And that you would just give them opportunities, Lord, to bless others as they're going to the different places that they go, because this represents lots of different schools. And I just thank you right now, God, for your presence, for your power. I thank you for their love for you. I know they all love you and serve you, and I'm so thankful for that. And I thank you that you put a presence in our schools through our young people and through our teachers. Just give you praise this morning, and thank you for what you're going to do this year. And we'll give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Please remain standing for just a moment. And let's see. I might need a helper here. Teachers may be seated. Okay, here you go, Terry. Here, I'm going to give you a bunch of these. You'll start on the stage here. Let's see. So your parents and your siblings are not here yet, but counting you, ¿cuántos seis? You have six. Wait, here, Terry. He has five other siblings, and I know two of them aren't in school yet, but they will be in school. So if you'll give these cards to your parents, and they can use those for school supplies for whatever they think they need. The younger ones may not need school supplies, but we don't want to leave those out. So do you have six? Okay, six. Okay. If you'll go and start with Kaylee, Gabe, Joseph, Cody. God bless you all. Now, just trust you all to use those for whatever you need. You may already have all your school supplies. Gabe's already trying to think what he's going to spend it on. All right, Gabe, read your mind. Troy needs one back there. Troy, because you'll need some school supplies. That's for you, Troy. You can give it to Mama. That's right. Use whatever you need it to. Okay. Now, Terry, would you give an extra one to Valerie for Maggie? She's not here today. And yes, this young girl's not in school yet, but Carly is. So, Glenna, why don't you give? I mean, Terry, why don't you give one for Carly? One for that baby. We'll get that baby something. Why? Need some more?
I got two left.
Here, get yours some more. Tiffany needs one. Here, put those in the bottom of the stack in case the bad ones down there. Tiffany needs one. Tiffany, there's one for you. Okay. Thank the Lord. No, let's see. I may give some more out after service. Let's see. Why don't you go back to Sabrina? And Sabrina, your grandsons were just here recently, so they may already have their school supplies, just in case. Okay, you may be seated if you got a card. I know it's no fun standing up in church. Okay, how are we doing on cards there?
You got four left. Five left.
You got five left. Let's see. Am I forgetting somebody, Glenna? I left my list there. Glenna's going to check our list just a moment. Yes, we need one for Lily and Joseph. So if you'll pull two out there for that. Yes, would you give what? How many do you have left now? Okay, would you give those to Carlisle? Carlisle, you probably have. I don't know how many do you have in school, Carlisle? Three. Well, that works out good. I know you have a couple more, but I think we're out. So, okay. So you got two left. Would you give those to Glenna? And Glenna can help us make sure we get those. Okay. Thank you. How about a big cheer for Terry? So don't forget to check the balance on your card before you use it, and then see me if one of them says it's no good, and I'll make it right. I would like to thank everyone who contributed to make this possible, because when you get $20 gift cards and you're buying 25 or so of them, it adds up a little bit. But they tell me things are different in school now than they used to be. Used to be, you know, you needed a lot more supplies, but now I guess they give you tablets or, I don't know, what do they give you, Kaylee? They give you tablets or computers or something? Or a hard time, they give you a hard time? Yeah. Definitely that. Okay. Well, thank the Lord. How about let's give the Lord a cheer for that. Thank you. Stand, please. We're going to worship the Lord as the praise team comes. Let's worship Him in spirit and in truth. God bless you.
Good morning, everybody. When he was passing those out, I thought about the song we're going to sing first. I thought I could change it up a little, Cody, and say, when I think about gift cards, how I'll spend them. Yeah, anyway, I won't actually sing that. But when I think about the Lord, how He saved me, how He raised me, how He filled me with the Holy Ghost, how He healed me to the uttermost. When I think about the Lord. How he picked me up and turned me around. How he blessed my feet on solid ground.
Worthy, Jesus. de alabanza y adoración.
He has a name above all names.
Tiene nombre sobre todo nombre.
The only name that can save us.
El único nombre que nos puede salvar.
You may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Pueden tomar asiento.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
Thank you for your presence.
Gracias por tu presencia.
Do you feel the presence of the Lord?
¿Pueden sentir la presencia del Señor?
It's easier if you bring him with you.
Es más fácil si lo traes contigo.
I know he's alive.
Yo sé que él está vivo.
I talked to him this morning.
Le hablé con él esta mañana.
Jesus is alive.
Jesús está vivo.
Who cares?
¿Qué importa?
Who cares?
¿A quién le importa?
That's the message today.
Es el mensaje.
I know people are making fun of that title.
Yo sé que muchos están riendo de ese título.
But maybe it'll ring true in your mind this week.
Pero a lo mejor será cierto esta semana.
Our world is full of hurting people.
Nuestro mundo de hoy está lleno de personas heridas.
You know anyone that's hurting?
¿Sabes a alguien que está dolido?
Our world is full of hurting people.
Nuestro mundo de hoy está lleno de personas heridas.
Hurting people who need the love of a caring God.
Personas heridas que necesitan el amor de un Dios bondadoso.
And are searching for someone to come alongside and minister that love in a relevant, effective way.
Y están buscando a alguien que se acerque y ministre ese amor de una manera relevante.
People are wounded and scarred by family fragmentation.
Las personas están heridas y marcadas por el fragmentación familiar.
Abandonment.
El abandono.
Materialism.
El rechazo, el materialismo.
Addiction and abuse.
La adicción y el abuso.
Do you know anyone like that?
¿Conocen a alguien así?
Have you ever been there yourself?
¿Han estado ahí tú mismo?
Tragically, when many of the pain-filled have needed care,
trágicamente, cuando muchos de los enfermos de dolor han necesitado atención,
their pain has often been compounded because they feel like no one cares.
Su dolor a menudo se ha agravado porque siente que nadie le importa.
Maybe you've been there before.
A lo mejor has estado en esa posición antes.
Where you've been hurting.
Que has estado doliendo.
And you feel like no one cares.
Y sientes que a nadie le importa.
That is a lie.
Es una mentira.
That's a lie from the enemy.
Es una mentira del enemigo.
He makes us feel like no one cares.
Nos hace sentir que nadie le importa.
In fact, he will plant thoughts in your mind.
Y él plantea pensamientos en tu
no
mente.
No one cares if I live or die.
Nadie le importa si yo vivo o muero.
If I died, it would make a difference to anyone.
Si yo me muero, no va a hacer diferencia para nadie.
The devil is a liar.
El diablo es un mentiroso.
He's the father of lies.
Él es el padre de la mentira.
Don't listen to him.
No lo escuches a él.
We need to resist him.
Tenemos que resistirlo.
And at the same time,
y a la misma vez,
get closer to the Lord.
Acercarnos al Señor.
Don't just resist him.
No solo lo resistes.
Say, I'm not going to think that. I'm not going to think that. I'm not going to think
that. No lo voy a pensar. No lo voy a pensar.
But instead of thinking that,
pero en vez de pensando en eso,
when I think about the Lord,
cuando pienso en el Señor,
how he saved me,
cómo me ha salvado,
how he raised me,
cómo me ha levantado,
how he filled me with the Holy Ghost,
cómo me llenó del Espíritu Santo,
how he healed me to the uttermost,
cómo me sanó hasta al profundo,
it makes me want to shout.
Me hace gritar.
Hallelujah.
Aleluya.
Can you say amen?
¿Pueden decir amén?
Our world is full of hurting people.
El mundo está lleno de personas heridas.
We live in a time when love is growing cold.
Vivimos en una época donde el amor se está enfriando.
When Jesus described the signs that would help us know when the end is near,
cuando Jesús describió las señales que nos ayudarían a saber si el fin está cerca,
Matthew 24:12 records that he said this.
Mateo 24:12 registra que él dijo,
because lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold.
Y por haberse multiplicado la maldad, el amor de muchos se enfriará.
I ask you, church.
Les pregunto, iglesia.
Are we living in a time where lawlessness abounds?
Estamos viviendo en un tiempo donde no hay, se multiplicó la maldad.
And many people don't have love.
Y muchos no tienen amor.
They don't love themselves.
No se aman ellos mismos.
They don't love others.
No aman a los demás.
They believe the lie of the devil.
Creen la mentira del diablo,
that no one cares,
que nadie le importa.
So if no one cares about me,
así que si nadie le importa de mí,
then why should I care about me?
Porque yo debo de importarme a mí mismo.
And sometimes they even hate themselves.
Y a veces se odian ellos mismos.
Do you know what people do that hate themselves?
¿Sabes lo que hace la gente cuando se odian?
They hate others.
Se odian a los demás.
Think about it.
Piénsalo.
If my life is worthless,
si mi vida no tiene sentido,
then what is your life worth?
¿Qué tiene sentido tu vida?
What difference does it make?
¿Qué diferencia hace?
If I get a rifle and shoot and kill people,
si agarro una pistola y mato a gente,
they don't matter.
No importa.
Because I don't matter.
Porque yo no importo.
And if I get killed,
y si a mí me mata,
who cares?
¿Qué les importa?
That's what the devil tries to do in your mind.
Es lo que el diablo intenta hacer en tu mente.
Many people do not care about people that are hurting.
A muchas personas no les importa lastimar a las personas.
They don't care that headlines are full of betrayal.
No les importa que los titulares estén llenos de traiciones.
Broken commitments.
Compromisos rotos.
Children left unprotected.
Niños desprotegidos.
Terrorism.
Terrorismo.
Ethnic cleansing.
Limpieza étnica.
And other evils.
Y otros males.
Doesn't sound like a very exciting message, does it?
No suena como un mensaje muy bueno.
But I'm trying to paint a picture of where we live.
Pero estoy tratando de pintar una imagen donde vivimos hoy.
In Luke chapter 11, Jesus gives us an example to pray.
En Lucas capítulo 11, Jesús nos dio un ejemplo para orar.
You may be familiar with that prayer.
A lo mejor pueden saber esta oración.
It begins like this.
Empieza así.
Padre nuestro que estás en los cielos, santificado sea tu nombre. Our Father which art in heaven.
I don't know in Spanish.
Oh. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Included in that prayer is that we should ask that God's will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Incluido en esa oración está que debemos pedir que se haga la voluntad de Dios en el tierra como en el cielo.
Do you know that prayer?
¿Saben esa oración?
Part of that prayer is thy will be done.
Parte de esa oración dice tu voluntad.
On earth as it is in heaven.
En el cielo como es en la tierra como es en el cielo.
That's what we pray.
Es lo que oramos.
That's how Jesus taught them to pray.
Es como Jesús enseñó a
orar. That's how Jesus teaches us to pray.
Así nos enseña a nosotros
a orar. He says when you pray,
cuando oras,
you should pray that God's will be done.
Debes de orar que la voluntad de Dios sea.
On earth like it is in heaven.
En la tierra como es en el cielo.
What do you think happens in heaven?
¿Qué crees lo que pasa en el cielo?
His way is the highway.
Su manera es la única manera.
What should happen here?
Lo que tiene que pasar aquí.
His way.
Su manera.
His way.
Su camino.
His will.
Su voluntad.
It is the will of God that we should be a caring people.
Es la voluntad de Dios que seamos un pueblo solidario.
It is God's will that we should be a caring people.
Es la voluntad de Dios que seamos un pueblo solidario.
Just in case you didn't get that.
Por si acaso no escucharon.
It is God's will that we should be a caring people.
Es la voluntad de Dios que seamos un pueblo solidario.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus described one neighbor going to the other for help to feed a visitor to his home.
Jesús describió a un vecino que iba el otro a buscar de ayuda para un visitante en su casa.
The other neighbor didn't seem to care.
El otro vecino no pareció importarle.
But the persistence of the other man convinced him to help.
Pero la persistencia del otro hombre lo convenció de que nos ayudara.
Jesus told us that we should ask.
Jesús nos dijo que debemos pedir.
Keep on asking.
Y seguir pidiendo.
Seek.
Buscar.
And keep on seeking.
Y seguir buscando.
And knock and keep on knocking.
Y llamar y seguir llamando.
That's that chapter 11 in Luke.
Ese es el capítulo 11 en Lucas.
Where he talks about how to pray.
Donde él habla cómo orar.
And then he tells us to keep on seeking.
Y nos enseña a seguir buscando.
Keep on knocking and asking.
Seguir llamando y pidiendo.
Don't give up.
No te des por vencido.
You care about people.
Si te importa la gente.
And nothing seems to change.
Y nada cambia.
Don't give up.
No te des por vencido.
Don't give up.
No te des por vencido.
Now listen to what Jesus said in Luke chapter 11, verse 11.
Ahora escuchemos lo que dice Jesús en Lucas capítulo 11, versículo 11.
If a son asks for bread from any father among you, will he give him a stone? Or if he asks for a fish, will he give him a serpent instead of a fish?
¿Qué padre de vosotros, si su hijo le pide pan, le dará una piedra? ¿O si pescado en lugar de pescado le dará una serpiente?
In verse 12.
En versículo 12.
¿O si le pide un huevo, le dará un escorpión?
Or if he asks for an egg, will he offer him a scorpion?
If you then, being evil, know how to give good gifts to your children,
pues si vosotros, siendo malos, sabéis dar buenas dádivas a vuestros hijos,
how much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?
¿Cuánto más vuestro Padre Celestial dará el Espíritu Santo a los que se le piden?
Who cares?
¿A quién le importa?
God cares.
Dios le importa.
God cares.
Dios le importa.
He wants to give us good things.
Él nos quiere dar buenas cosas.
He wants us to give to others.
Él quiere que le demos a los demás.
God wants us to care enough about the people around us to help them.
Dios quiere que nos preocupemos lo suficiente por las personas que nos rodean para ayudarlas.
Is there anyone who doesn't know anybody that's hurting?
¿Alguien aquí no conoce a nadie que está doliendo?
You don't have to look far.
No tienes que mirar lejos.
Sometimes you just look in the mirror.
A veces puedes mirar al espejo.
Right.
¿Verdad?
We need to be aware.
Tenemos que estar atentos.
Of people that are hurting.
De gente que está doliendo.
And God wants us to care.
Y Dios quiere que nos preocupemos.
You see, if you care about people that are hurting,
porque si nos preocupamos de la gente que está doliendo,
you don't really have to be motivated to help them.
No tienes que estar motivado para ayudarles.
If you love people,
si amas a la gente,
you don't have any problem praying for them.
No tienes problema de orar por ellos.
So we need to love.
Así tenemos que amar.
And we need to care.
Y tenemos que preocuparnos.
God wants us to care enough about the people around us to help them.
Dios quiere que nos preocupemos lo suficiente por las personas que nos rodean para ayudarlas.
Because unfortunately,
porque desafortunadamente,
people have needed security of stable homes, but have received breakdown of marriages and families.
Las personas han necesitado la seguridad de hogares estables, pero han recibido ruptura de matrimonios y familias.
People have needed warmth of caring affection, but have received abuse at the hand of pleasure takers.
La gente ha necesitado el calor del afecto, pero ha recibido abuso a manos de los que toman placeres.
People have needed affirmation of worth and value, but have received the devaluation of betrayal and discrimination.
Las personas han necesitado afirmación de valía, y valor, pero han recibido la desvaloración y de la traición y la discriminación.
We are living in a day in which people have needed bread and have received stones.
Vivimos en una época en la que la gente necesita pan y ha recibido piedras.
Ahora ponga atención, por favor.
Now pay attention, please.
Hurting people are looking for the real God.
Las personas heridas están buscando al Dios verdadero.
And when they hear that he is the Father of compassion and God of all comfort,
pero cuando escuchan que él es el Padre de la compasión y Dios de todo consuelo,
they hear that,
escuchan eso,
but they still don't know who he is.
Y todavía no saben quién es.
Because they have yet to experience from caring followers of Jesus what comfort looks and feels like.
Porque aún no han experimentado de los seguidores de Jesús lo que se ve y se siente como el consuelo.
So what kind of people should we be?
¿Qué tipo de personas debemos de ser?
Troy, what kind of people should we be?
Troy, ¿qué tipo de personas deberíamos ser?
Good people, amen.
Buenas personas, amen.
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 The Apostle Peter ends his second letter asking this question.
El apóstol Pedro termina su segunda carta haciendo esta pregunta.
But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heavens will pass away with a great noise, and the elements will melt with fervent heat. Both the earth and the works that are in it will be burned up.
Pero el día del Señor vendrá como ladrón en la noche, en el cual los cielos pasarán con grandes estruendos, y los elementos ardiendo serán deshechos. Y la tierra y las obras que hay en ellas serán quemadas.
So sometime today,
a lo mejor hoy,
just take a look at everything around you.
Toma tiempo para mirar todo alrededor de ti.
It's not eternal.
No es eternal.
There's going to be a new heaven.
Va a haber un nuevo cielo.
And a new earth.
Y una nueva tierra.
What's going to happen to all of this?
¿Qué va a pasar con todo esto?
Somebody tell me what's going to happen.
Alguien dígame qué va a pasar.
It's going to burn up.
Se va a quemar.
It's going to burn up.
Se va a quemar.
It's all going to be gone.
Todo se va a ir.
Verse 11.
Versículo 11.
Therefore,
puesto,
since all these things will be destroyed,
que todas estas cosas han de ser deshechas,
what manner of persons ought you to be in holy conduct and godliness?
¿Cómo no debéis vosotros andar en santa y piadosa manera de vivir?
In other words, since you realize all of this is going away,
en otras palabras, si sabes que todo esto se va a ir,
what should that do in our hearts and our minds?
¿Qué tiene que hacer eso en nuestros corazones y en nuestra mente?
It should encourage us to care about others.
Nos tiene que motivar para preocuparnos de los demás.
We want others to know Jesus like we know Jesus.
Queremos que los demás conozcan a Jesús como nosotros conocemos a Jesús.
We should be touched when we see others that are hurting.
Nos debe tocar cuando miramos algo a alguien que está doliendo.
All this that you see is going to be destroyed.
Todo esto que tú miras será destruido.
It's going to burn up.
Se va a quemar.
Okay, so those of you that are in school.
Así que los que están en la escuela.
What are you supposed to do if you catch on fire? Anybody know?
¿Qué se supone que debes hacer si te enciendes?
Gabe, you know?
Gabe, ¿sabes?
If you were to catch on fire, your body catches. Do you know?
Si tú te enciendes.
I'm sorry?
Detenerse, tirarse, revolcarse.
Did you read that?
¿Lo leíste?
You knew it.
Tú lo sabías, ¿verdad?
They teach you that.
Nos enseñan eso.
God, isn't that what they teach people?
Es lo que enseñan a la gente.
If you're on fire, don't keep running.
Si estás ardiendo, no corras.
You're just fanning the flame.
Si solo haces que la llama sea más grande.
You're not getting away from it.
No corres de la llama.
It's getting worse and worse.
Se va a empeorar.
Stop.
Para.
And then drop.
Tírate.
And then roll around.
Y revólcase.
Hopefully somebody will help put out the fire.
Ojalá alguien pueda ayudarte.
They teach us that as children, don't they?
Nos enseñan eso desde niños, ¿verdad?
And as a little child, I wonder.
Y desde niño yo pensaba.
If you start thinking about catching on fire.
Piensas en...
If you start thinking about catching on fire.
Piensas en cómo sería arderse.
They told me in school, if you catch on fire, stop, drop, and roll.
Me decían en la escuela, si te enciendes, detente, tírase y revólcase.
Some little boy got real excited.
Un niño se hizo muy motivado.
He went home and told his mom, I think we're going to catch on fire.
Fue con su mamá y le dijo, a lo mejor nos van a prender fuego.
Because they told us what to do.
Porque nos dijeron qué hacer.
Stop, drop, and roll.
Detenerse, tirarse y revolcarse.
Did you know our God is a consuming fire?
¿Saben que nuestro Dios es un fuego consumidor?
You know that?
¿Sabían eso?
That's what the Bible teaches.
Es lo que la Biblia enseña.
God wants to set us on fire spiritually.
Dios nos quiere encender espiritualmente.
In fact, John the Baptist said of Jesus.
Y Juan el Bautista le dijo a Jesús.
John was baptizing with water.
Juan estaba bautizando con agua.
He baptized Jesus in water.
Bautizó a Jesús en agua.
He said, "There's somebody coming after me," John said.
Y Juan dijo que hay alguien detrás de mí.
He's mightier than I am.
Que es más grande que yo.
I'm not even worthy to touch his shoes.
Yo no soy digno ni de tocar sus sandalias.
I baptized with water. I baptized with water.
Yo bautizo con la agua.
But John says, "The one that's coming after me."
Pero el que viene detrás de mí.
He will baptize you.
Él te bautizará.
With the Holy Ghost.
Con el Espíritu Santo.
By helping.
Y alguien ayúdame.
And fire.
Y fuego.
And fire.
Y fuego.
The Holy Ghost and fire.
El Espíritu Santo y fuego.
So physically speaking.
Así que físicamente.
Cody, if you catch on fire.
Cody, si te enciendes.
You would like for it to go out.
Quieres que se apague.
But spiritually speaking.
Pero espiritualmente.
You want to be consumed in it.
Quieres ser consumido en él.
See, spiritual things are different than physical things.
Las cosas espirituales son diferentes de las físicas.
Por ejemplo,
for example,
if you like food,
si te gusta la comida,
if you eat too much,
si comes de más,
you will become a full gospel preacher.
Vas a ser un lleno ministerio.
You can eat too much.
Puedes comer de más.
At some point you should stop.
Y algún punto debes de parar.
But spiritually thinking,
pero espiritualmente,
spiritually speaking, if you eat of the things of God, you taste and see the Lord is good.
Si comes de las cosas del Señor, pruebas si son buenas.
It doesn't make you full.
No te llena.
It makes you hungry.
Te hace más hambriento.
Isn't that interesting?
Es algo interesante.
So physically speaking, if you catch on fire,
así que físicamente,
stop,
si te sientes,
drop, and roll.
Deténse, tirarse y revolcarse.
But if you're spiritually on fire,
pero si estás espiritualmente en fuego,
there's a different reaction.
Hay una reacción diferente.
May God light a fire in us to care about others, so we will stop, look, and listen.
Que Dios encienda un fuego en nosotros para que nos preocupemos por los demás, para que lo hagamos deténganse, mirar y escuchar.
As the fire of God consumes us,
mientras que el fuego del Señor nos consume,
we need to stop, look, and listen.
Tenemos que parar, mirar y escuchar.
We need to stop and notice people.
Tenemos que parar y observar a las personas.
Let the fire of God cause us to stop and notice other people.
Tenemos que dejar que el fuego de Dios nos detenga y observar a las personas.
We can get so busy looking into our own lives.
Nos preocupamos tanto en nuestras propias vidas.
And not notice anyone else.
Y no miramos a las otras personas.
Por ejemplo.
For example.
Soon, Kaylee, you're going to be getting a driver's license at some point, right?
Muy pronto vas a tener una licencia de manejo, ¿verdad, Kaylee?
Mom, she's
Mama.
Going to get a driver's license at some point.
We're not talking about that right now.
So, Kaylee, when you learn to drive,
cuando aprendas a manejar,
you will notice that there are several mirrors.
Puedes notar que hay muchos espejos.
There's one to look in the back.
Uno para mirar atrás.
You have one on either side.
Uno en cada lado.
Algunas veces.
Y sometimes
you even have one when you back up.
Tienes uno donde para reversear, una cámara.
But that rear view mirror in the front.
Pero ese espejo en el frente.
Now, Kaylee, if you're going to see a young man that you like.
Kaylee, si vas a ir a buscar a un niño que te gusta.
You can turn that mirror.
Puedes voltear ese espejo.
So you can see how beautiful you look.
Para mirar qué bonita te miras.
But Kaylee, if you continue to drive down the road,
pero si continúas manejando en la carretera,
looking at the mirror,
mirándote a ti misma,
and admiring yourself,
y mirándote a ti misma,
you might have a problem.
A lo mejor vas a tener un problema.
Okay. I mean, you'll look great.
Te vas a mirar bien.
But you might run someone over.
Pero a lo mejor vas a atropellar a alguien.
So we want God's fire in us to consume us.
Si queremos el fuego de Dios que nos consuma.
So we stop and notice people.
Así que nos paramos y observamos a la gente.
Notice that person that waits on you today if you go somewhere to eat.
Mira a alguien que te espera hoy cuando van a ir a comer.
You know, it used to be if you went to get gas
antes,
for your car,
era que si ibas a agarrar gasolina para tu carro,
you had to pay someone.
Tenías que pagarle a alguien.
First you had to pay them when they came to your car.
Primero le tenías que pagar cuando vienen a tu carro.
And then sometimes you go inside to pay them.
Y a veces tienes que ir adentro para pagarles.
And then they changed things so you could just put a card into the pump.
Y luego cambiaron las cosas para solo poner la tarjeta.
You didn't have to have contact with anyone.
Y no tenías que hablar con nadie.
Now you don't even have to put your card in.
Ahora ni siquiera tienes que meter la tarjeta.
You can just touch it.
Puedes tocarlo.
No contact with people.
Sin contacto con la gente.
Valerie, used to be if you needed money.
Antes era si necesitabas dinero.
Not that we had any.
De, no que teníamos.
But you'd go to the bank.
Pero ibas al banco.
And you stand in line.
Y te paras en línea.
And you withdraw some money. You had contact with people.
Y tienes que sacar dinero. Con, hablabas con
you
gente.
You do all that without any contact.
Ahora puedes hacer todo eso sin hablar con
nadie. Used to be if you were hungry, you went out to get a meal.
Antes era que si tenías hambre y vas afuera a agarrar algo de comer.
You would sit at a table and somebody would wait on you.
Te sentabas en una mesa y esperabas.
You pay them or someone else.
Le pagabas a esa persona o alguien más.
Or you could just go up to a counter and ask somebody.
O puedes ir al frente a preguntarle a alguien.
Now you can drive through.
Ahora puedes ir en el carro.
Have a little bit of contact.
Un poco de hablar.
Or in some places they don't want you to go to the counter.
En otros lugares no quieres que vaya al frente.
They want you to work for them for free.
Quieres que trabajes por ellos gratis.
And go to the machine and order it yourself.
Y ve a la máquina y ordena tú mismo.
Next thing you know, James, they're going to want us to cook it ourselves.
Lo siguiente, a lo mejor nos van a hacer cocinar la comida.
I can do that at home.
Lo puedo hacer en la casa.
Can you see how the technology of this world is isolating us?
¿Miras cómo esta tecnología del mundo nos está separando?
It used to be.
Antes era,
if you had friends,
si tenías amigos,
you would go see them.
Los ibas a ver.
They would come see you.
Ellos te venían a ver.
You would do things together.
Hacían cosas juntas.
And now they just hang out on some virtual wall.
Ahora se están juntos en una pared virtual.
Or we text them.
O le mandamos mensajes.
Or we exchange messages.
O cambiamos mensajes.
See that the enemy doesn't want us to have contact with people.
El enemigo no quiere que hablemos con la gente.
Doesn't want us to notice people.
No quiere que notemos a la gente.
Jesus and his followers often did this.
Jesús y sus seguidores a menudo hacían esto.
They noticed people.
Ellos notaban a las personas.
They stopped and paid attention to a specific person around them.
Ellos se detuvieran y se enfocaran en una sola persona.
Jesus did that often.
Jesús hizo eso mucho.
Learning to care effectively for others requires giving close attention.
Aprender a cuidar eficazmente de los demás requiere prestar mucha atención.
Which can be difficult if you are too busy with activities, tasks, or other things.
Lo que puede ser difícil si estás demasiado ocupado con actividades, tareas, o otras cosas.
You can expect divine encounters.
Puedes esperar encuentros divinos.
God's going to be in that.
Dios va a estar en eso.
When you slow down and you pause to notice others.
Cuando bajas la velocidad y hagas una pausa para observar a los demás.
I challenge you.
Te reto.
Next time you have a choice,
la siguiente vez que tengas una opción,
between having personal contact,
de contacto personal,
or no contact,
o no contacto,
have a little contact.
Agarra un poco de contacto.
Even if you pay for your gas at the pump,
aunque nomás pagues para la gasolina,
take a moment and go inside the store.
Toma un momento y ve adentro de la tienda.
And Jim, tell the person that's working in the store.
Y dile a la persona que está trabajando en esa tienda.
Hello, how are you doing?
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Jim, you wouldn't mind that, would you?
No te dolería eso, ¿verdad?
As long as they don't walk out without paying for anything.
Al menos que no se salgan sin pagar.
Jim is fine.
Él estaría bien.
And if they say they're fine,
y si dicen que están bien,
that's what most people say.
Es lo que dice mucha gente.
You can say, well, that's great.
Puedes decir, eso es bueno.
Is there anything I can pray for you about?
¿Hay algo que pueda orar por ti?
Add it to your prayer list.
Y agregarlo a tu lista de oración.
You'd be surprised.
Vas a ser sorprendido.
I asked a waitress that question one time.
Yo le pregunté eso a una servidora una vez.
I don't need prayer.
Y dice, no necesito oración.
And then she walked away when she came back.
Y se fue, y cuando regresó,
tears running down her face.
Tenía,
she was crying.
Estaba llorando.
She said, pray for my grandma.
Dice, ora por mi abuela.
I said, we'll pray for your grandma and pray for you too.
Oraremos por tu abuela y por ti también.
Slow down.
Espera.
Stop.
Para.
Notice people.
Y observa la gente.
Let the fire of God consume us.
Deja que el fuego del Señor nos consuma.
So we don't just stop.
Así que no solo nos detuvimos.
But while we stop, we look.
Pero mientras que nos detuvimos, a observar.
Look for the pain of aloneness.
Mira el dolor de la soledad.
Remember the story of Jesus at the pool of Bethesda?
¿Recuerdas a Jesús en el estanque de Bethesda?
He saw a man who was alone and had no one to help him.
Vio a un hombre que estaba solo y no tenía nadie que le ayudara.
Jesus wants us to stop and notice people.
Jesús quiere que paremos y observemos
and
a la gente.
Look for that pain of a lonely person.
Y mira ese dolor de una persona solitaria.
Do you know that one of the gifts of the Spirit?
¿Sabes que uno de los dones del Espíritu?
Is discernment.
Es
to be able to tell how things are.
Podré mirar cómo son las cosas.
The Lord can help us to do that.
El Señor nos puede ayudar a hacer eso.
People face losses.
Las personas enfrentan pérdidas.
Trauma.
Traumas.
Broken relationships.
Relaciones rotas.
Or failures, but they often face them alone.
O fracasos, pero a menudo las enfrentan solas.
When pain is dealt with alone,
cuando el dolor se trata solo,
it may be manifested in these symptoms.
Puede manifestarse en estos síntomas.
Withdrawal,
como el retraimiento,
anger,
la ira,
control,
el control,
manipulation,
la manipulación,
procrastination,
la procrastinación,
physical disorders,
los trastornos físicos,
and other ways.
Y otras formas.
We need to notice that the aloneness others feel and offer them Jesus.
Necesitamos darnos cuentas de la soledad que sienten los demás y ofrecerles a Jesús.
Who will always be with them.
Que siempre estará con ellos.
The enemy says no one cares.
El enemigo dice a nadie le importa.
No one loves.
Nadie ama.
Our message is.
Nuestro mensaje es.
We care.
Nosotros nos importa.
He cares.
A él le importa.
He loves you.
Y él te ama.
We love you.
Nosotros te amamos.
You can accept him.
Puedes aceptarlo a él.
And never be alone.
Y nunca estar solo.
So stop.
Así que detente.
And look.
Y observa.
Y también escucha.
And listen.
Listen for words of aloneness.
Escucha las palabras de soledad.
When Jesus met the woman at the well,
cuando Jesús se encontró con la mujer en el pozo,
he spoke with her and listened to her.
Habló con ella y la escuchó.
A divorced woman.
La mujer viuda.
A woman who had five husbands.
Una mujer que tenía cinco esposos.
And the man she was with.
Y al,
was not her husband.
Y el hombre con quien estaba no era su esposo.
The followers of Jesus.
Eran seguidores de Jesús.
Would certainly not have spoken to her.
No hablaban con ella.
They would not have paid attention to her.
No le ponían atención.
Jesus did.
Jesús sí le dio atención.
We need to listen for loneliness.
Tenemos que escuchar por las palabras de soledad.
We need to listen for pain beneath the surface.
Tenemos que escuchar el dolor debajo de la superficie.
Sometimes aloneness is revealed by incessant words.
A veces la soledad se revela con palabras insensatas.
People just talk and talk and talk and talk.
La gente habla y habla y habla.
But they don't really say anything.
Pero no dicen nada.
Or quick spiritual platitudes.
O tópicos espirituales rápidos
that seek to disguise the lonely, disconnected heart underneath.
Que buscan disfrazar el corazón solitario.
Sometimes the words are cries for help.
A veces las palabras son gritos de ayuda.
Such as,
como,
I don't know if I can go on.
No sé si puedo seguir.
Maybe you've never said that.
A lo mejor nunca has dicho eso.
Maybe you've never heard it.
A lo mejor nunca lo has escuchado.
I've heard it.
Yo lo he escuchado.
And I've said it.
Y yo lo he dicho.
So I know.
So yo sé.
Jesus spoke to the lack of lasting relationships in this woman's life.
Jesús habló de la falta de relaciones duraderas en la vida de la mujer.
With him and with her husbands.
Con él y con sus esposos.
People around us are in pain.
Las personas alrededor están sufriendo.
People around us are in pain.
Están sufriendo.
They're hurting over a loss or rejection.
Están sufriendo por una pérdida o rechazo.
Discouraged by failure.
Desanimados por el fracaso.
Or afraid of the future.
O temerosos del futuro.
¿A quién le importa?
Who cares?
¿A quién le importa?
Who cares?
Who cares?
¿A quién le importa?
We should care.
Debemos preocuparnos.
Like Jesus does.
Como lo hace Jesús.
Would you stand, please?
Si se pueden poner de pie.
When I was preparing this message,
mientras que preparaba este mensaje,
I said, Lord, you know who will be here.
Dije, Señor, tú sabes quién va a estar aquí.
You know what they need to hear.
Tú sabes lo que tienen que escuchar.
Maybe you're in that situation.
A lo mejor estás en esa situación.
Maybe you feel like no one really cares.
Te sientes como que nadie le importa.
I'm here to tell you that Jesus cares.
Y estoy aquí para decirte que Jesús le importa.
Maybe you're here today.
A lo mejor estás aquí hoy.
And you say, I know that people hurt around me.
Y yo sé que la gente está doliendo alrededor.
But I don't really stop and notice.
Pero yo no me paro para observar.
I don't look to see if they're alone.
Yo miro, no miro si están solos.
I don't take time to listen to them.
No tomo tiempo para escucharlos.
If you're here today and you feel like no one cares,
si estás aquí hoy y sientes que a nadie le importa,
I'd love to pray for you.
Me gustaría orar por ti.
If you're here today and you know you need to care more,
si estás aquí y sabes que necesitas importar más,
I'd love to
observar
pray
más, quiero orar por ustedes.
Would you bow your heads?
¿Pueden inclinar sus rostros?
I certainly don't want you to raise your hand.
No quiero que levanten las manos.
But I want you to answer this question just to the Lord.
Pero quiero que respondan esta respuesta, esta pregunta al Señor.
If you're here today and you feel like no one cares,
si estás aquí hoy y sientes que nadie le importa,
just confess that to Jesus right now.
Solo confiésalo al Señor hoy.
He's prepared a time that you can pray.
Él ha preparado tiempo para que ores.
And trust him.
Y confiar en él.
Someone told me years ago that
alguien me dijo hace años,
when people's hearts are being dealt with in the pew,
cuando los corazones están enfrentados aquí en el altar,
and they surrender to the Lord and come to pray,
y se rinden al Señor y vienen a orar,
he said often their prayer is answered as they're walking to the altar.
A veces las oraciones son respondidas mientras que ellos vienen.
They've already surrendered.
Ya se han rendido.
If you need to surrender to him today, you can come or you can pray where you are.
Si tienes que rendirte ante él, puedes venir o orar donde estás.
But if you don't feel like that's the right time for you to do that right now,
pero si no sientes que es el tiempo correcto,
would you just pray with me?
Pueden orar conmigo.
Let's pray.
Orar.
Pray for those who are hurting.
Orar por los que están doliendo.
Jesus, we love you. We call on your great name, the only name that can save us, the name that we worship together this morning. Call on your great name, Jesus. Lord, I have been hurting before. I have been in a situation where I felt like no one cares. I realize that is an attack of the enemy. But Lord, when we're under that attack, sometimes it's difficult to see clearly. Lord, I'm persuaded that in this group that is here right now, there are people that are hurting. Lord, the question may rise up in their mind and spirit, who cares? Remind them that others care about them. May we show it with our love. You said, Lord, this is how the world is going to know we follow you, if we have love one to another. Fill our hearts with love. Help us to stop, to notice, to look. Help us to listen. Oh God, I pray for lonely hearts today. Remind them that they are not alone. You are always with them. Oh God, make your presence real to them. May it feel more realistic than it has ever before. Lord, and at times when they're attacked with loneliness, would you help them to overcome the attack of the enemy and reach out to someone? And would you help us, Lord, when we're not in that situation, we're not hurting, to be aware enough that we would reach out to others? Lord, it means so much to someone to hear someone say they love them. They're praying for them. Not only to hear it, but to see it. To see love in action. And to have someone actually pray for them. So Lord, I'm praying for anyone here who's hurting. I pray that your power and your presence, your peace would rest on them, Jesus. And Lord, would you motivate each of us? Consume us with your fire. May you burn in us and through us so much, Lord, that we will obey your word and be faithful to you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your word. Thank you for ministering to us through your word. I believe your word is truth and strength. I believe it feeds us. We need it, Lord. Not just on a Sunday morning. We need it every day. Let your word take a place of prominence in our lives, preeminence in our life. May it be important to us, Lord. Help us not to go about our busy day without spending some time with you in prayer and in your word. It will bless us, Jesus. It will help us to see things as you see them. Thank you, Lord, for my brothers and sisters. Lord, I am so blessed to be among a people who are willing to listen to the word of God. Lord, I give you glory for whatever good has been said and whatever has been said that maybe didn't need to be said. I take responsibility for it, Lord. That was me. But the good comes from you for every good and perfect gift that comes from the Father above doesn't change. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. Be blessed in Jesus' name.